It's New Year's Day, got up late, so already losing the light. Been for a walk, and I thought I'd share some tips with you. I'm not a huge fan of resolutions. I think these things should evolve over the year, but here are my top 10 tips. So number one is make a plan. Have objectives, have goals, and every day, week, month, quarter, depending on what they are, take a look at where you are, look at the progress, look what you need to change, what you need to sort of adjust, seek support if necessary, and then carry on and reach those objectives. Number two is follow a passion. I don't care whether it's your career, your personal life, it's a hobby or even a business, or turning a hobby into a business or passion into a business. Do something you enjoy doing. That's what life's about. So find a passion and inject some time, energy, and focus into it. Number three, and I said this a lot in 2018, but be yourself, be true to yourself. Don't worry about what people think you should be doing. Don't worry about what your family think what your life should look like, or what career you should follow, or whether you should start a business. Be true to who you really are. Only you know who you really are, and stick to it. Now, seek guidance, seek counsel, absorb it, listen to it, take from it. But at the end of the day, go and do whatever it is you need to do. Number four is focus. So you need to focus because your time, your energy, your resources, your money is finite. So you can only invest it in so many things and only so much in each thing. So look at what it is you want to achieve, make a list of the top three, prioritize, and focus your resources very carefully and manage it. Number five, something I need to do is learn something new. Apply your time, your skills, your energy into maybe a language, be it a new skill in your career, or you know, continuous professional development, or something in your business to help you be a better leader. Develop a new skill. Number six, get out of your comfort zone. Face your fears. We all live in cocoons of comfort. Get outside of it. That's where you learn who you really are. That's where you learn what you are capable of. That's where you push your boundaries. That's where you make a difference, where you add value to your life and to the lives of other people. Number seven, people. People matter. So whether it's your friends, family, colleagues, people that work for you, your co-founders, choose them very, very carefully. Anyone that's detracting from your life, who's negative, who's sucking you down, eject them from your life. Now, where you're working with people, make sure that they are adding value, that you see eye to eye, there's a common objective, and people are there just to make themselves feel better. If you're having a tough time and they're not there for you, that's when you find out who your friends really are. But remember this, it doesn't matter what you do in life, it's about people. Business is about people. Innovation is about sharing ideas amongst people. So make sure you have the right people in your life, or it's going to be very, very hard to be happy and to succeed. And one more point about people is this. There's always someone that we've fallen out with, there's been a tiff with, who could be friends, could be family, someone you know adds value to your life and somebody you care about. Clear the air, make that phone call, go and have a coffee with them and sort it out. Number eight, well-being. Take it seriously. Simple one. Eat well, eat as well as you can afford, eat less if you need to, move more if you have to. Most of us do need to move more, I need to move more. And take your well-being very, very seriously, because if you're not healthy, you're not happy. If you're not healthy, it's very hard to be positive, it's very hard to succeed in anything you do. Number nine, manage social media. It's okay me saying that, standing here doing this, but look at it very simply in these terms, cost, benefit. The cost is your energy, it's your time. You can lose a lot of time staring at your phone and social media, worrying about what other people are doing or where they are or how happy they are. Don't worry about that. Just take from it what makes sense to take from it. And that's about the cost benefit. What's the benefit? What are you getting from it? Are you learning? Is it opening your mind? Is it making a difference to your life? Is it adding value? And if not, don't look at it. Cut it out or cut down on it. Number 10 is give back. Doesn't matter who you are, where you are in life, how much you've got, there's always someone that needs help or support. And I don't mean it's about giving money. Give your time, give your ideas, start a business that improves the world, but give back. Somebody once said to me, and it's actually in their coat of arms, and I've always thought about this, is do well, do good. Doesn't matter how small, give back. Now that's 10. Now there's a bonus tip here, or tips, and this is about applying it to business. So if you're thinking of starting a business, go through my top 10 tips, because they're all applying one way or the other. And this can be starting a passion, it can be focusing, it can be, you know, and start small, start online, start while you're working for somebody else, try things out. But just try. The future of employment is self-employment. And if you're thinking of scaling your business up, then growing a business, you know, it can be nerve-wracking. It does involve risk. It may involve involving other people, external stakeholders. It doesn't mean you shouldn't grow your business. I always ask people in a room with businesses, hands up, who doesn't want to grow their business? Because in this day and age, not growing or not having at least a plan of how to grow, or at least stay at the same level, is dangerous. The world's changed, markets are very dynamic, consumers are fickle. So have a plan to grow your business. And that's about, look at some of my content, that's about execution, people, strategy, technology, and how you finance it as well. So they're my top 10 tips for 2019, call them resolutions if you like. Hope there's some relevance there for some of you. If there is, let me know. Please join my YouTube channel. Follow me on social media at Piers Linney, on LinkedIn, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube. And I'm looking forward to spending more time with you and sharing more content and ideas with you and continue the debate throughout 2019.